You've been bugging all day, bro. Who's better, Big or Pac?
Pac's way better than Big, bro.
How? Big is a way better spitter than him.
He's not a better spitter than Pac, bro. Pac got way more content.
I didn't ask you about content. Who's better, LeBron?
What's going on, y'all? Welcome to Orwell's World. I want to thank you for tuning in. You, as always, I got my man Kanan to the right of me. Say what up one time.
Nah, I got some issues. I'm not going to say, don't, as always. This nigga's been trying to write me off the show for 3 months and can't find a better co-host, you know what I'm saying? So, hey, I'm back, you know what I'm saying? He's like,
that's not what happened.
Nigga, call me like, okay. I need you. Have you seen these people?
That's not what happened either.
These people.
That's not what happened.
He was calling y'all these people. Yeah.
What do you mean, you people?
Yeah, uh-huh.
You first of all. Was.
Nah, first of all, nothing.
First of all.
We can hear you. Who you talking to? Nah. Give us a number. You're going to call him on the podcast right now. You got something to talk about? Let's talk. Ruin shit. Nah. And we got L's. And who else we got L's?
say what up one time.
And whoever's on the phone, say what's good.
If you're on YouTube or on Facebook, make sure you like, you comment, and you subscribe.
On YouTube, and then what do you like the page?
Like the page and follow the page.
You can follow the page and share it.
Share, man. Just keep sharing, keep liking, keep subscribing.
Sharing is caring.
Send it to that girl that you wanted to get with in high school, but you just never had the confidence to talk
to her. You just couldn't talk to her.
Because you don't know.
Send us over. We'll talk to her for you.
I'm saying, maybe she got like 5 kids now. She's shaped like a Bentley.
You don't want it. You don't even want it no more.
Hey, this nigga said shaped like a Bentley.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Big body.
Yeah, them be the funniest memes. Like, try to tell her in high school and there's a picture and then it's like,
oh, but because the reason why it's a meme, because it's true.
It's real life.
Oh, definitely.
It was real life. I remember, yo, I'm not gonna hurt no one, I'm not saying no names, but I know some bitches that peaked out in like 7th grade.
Whoa.
This nigga said peaked out in 7th grade.
He knows what I'm talking about.
Whoa.
He knows a few of them.
Had a kid in all.
Bro, nah. They just peaked out at 7th and 7th
grade.
How are
you the baddest bitch alive in 6th grade? Like, that don't make no sense.
Yeah.
And bro.
Life.
Downhill.
Life got to them real fucking early.
Damn.
Them old ass cougar motherfuckers, low-key pedophile niggas got to them.
I was going
to
say, so if old ladies are cougars, what are the old niggas called? Jaguars? That's fire.
Retarded.
I've never heard that.
Jaguars?
I've never heard that term before, but we should make that a thing.
I don't think I want to make it a thing. I don't want to promote that.
I mean, not
pedophilia, but.
No, not like, well, okay. I mean, I think that's kind of what you were kind of saying.
Yes.
Think about it. But no, I'm talking about like. You know what I'm talking about, them old, like, you've been 19 once.
You stupid.
And went to the wrong party. And like, ma'am.
Like, how old are you? Like,
45.
Really?
Like, my mom. You older than my mom. Right? Like, I don't think I want to do this.
What?
I'm paying for them Jordans. Look, that's a sable tooth tiger. That's not.
Yeah, nigga, because she pushed the mercury sable.
Yo.
Yeah. Rolly was there.
That's funny. That is funny. You're an asshole for that.
I'm back. I'm back, baby.
That's a crazy insider, but anyway.
This nigga's Young Berg right
let's
now.
Talk. Let's nah, he ain't.
That song
wilding.
Might have been playing.
No,
I'm
no.
Wild.
Did he drink? No, he was bugging. Why he say that? Why did he say that about Whitney? No, I didn't even see the Whitney shit. I was talking.
Hey, sexy lady.
I'm talking about when he was talking about Nari. No,
it was nice to know.
He was telling how Ray J was. Time out. He was talking about how Ray J was smashing Whitney Houston.
That's
oh shit. He was though.
Yeah. But I don't think anyone knew that. Like,
I mean,
like,
I didn't know that.
He like,
you didn't know that?
I could have probably. I mean, that's not a Google I have ever.
I know,
used.
I, nigga, he was that. Who's was that right? Was that is joint at one point. That's mad weird I to say.
That,
but
you can't say that terminology should have never come.
Talk about Whitney Houston. I can't say that about Whitney Houston.
It's Ray J's joint.
It was.
Nigga, it's Whitney Houston. Watch your mouth. I punch you. I don't care if she was a crackhead or whatever. I'll hit you.
My bad. You're right.
He's like,
rest in peace to the queen.
Time out.
I walked in Ray J's room and she was naked. Get out of here, Young Berg. I'm like, yo,
Young Berg. Get out of here, Young Berg.
Boy, he said he was fucking Nari Nolton. And he was like
from 3LW.
The dark skin joint, and she'd be on Power or whatever, the mom from Power.
Not the one that had the broken promises?
No. No. That's she's light skin. Now the dark skin, the dark skin girl
that no one knew. I don't know her.
Maybe
no
one knows
her. I don't know.
Nigga, he said he was like, yeah, I was fucking her, and I found out what an IUD was. Boy, why are you telling this woman's business? Like, what is wrong with you?
Who's this, Young Bird?
Yeah, like,
nigga, he's what's this nigga's name now?
Hitmaker.
Hitmaker, yeah, right?
Nigga said, yo, I thought she had a mouse trap in her pussy.
Like, yo. Not wild. See, that drink champ shit get niggas in trouble,
what?
Boy.
I've never, what is this? Going what, is this what is this show?
You drink never watched Drink Champs?
This sounds like real sex on HBO in 2020. Now it's called Drink Champs?
What? No. It's Nori's, it's Nori's podcast.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right. I know what the fuck.
This
y'all niggas.
This nigga is crazy.
I didn't say that. I never fucked Whitney.
Me neither.
So real sex. When was Ray J fucking Whitney Houston?
Boy, this was.
When she died? What year did Whitney Houston die? Cause yeah, look that yeah exactly.
No, the question is, no, did Ray J smoke butter with?
Oh my god!
You think she was smoking?
What
smoking
is wrong
cream?
With y'all?
Smoking mad woolies.
Yo,
smoking
woolies.
Nigga said the cream, nah. Said, had this
what is wrong with y'all, son?
I'm just saying, yo,
bro. We're getting
Ray
banned.
J didn't have Whitney.
He either smoked, we are getting so, banned.
He either
boy.
Smoked a woolie or he tooted a line. Something.
He might have had her
he
going to get the soap.
Tooted a line. You're wilding.
Oh yeah, Ray J's what? Not cocaine. He's a Hollywood.
Yeah, I'm about to say he's
human.
Born and raised in Hollywood. Yeah, hell yeah,
that nigga's Hollywood.
He's been famous his whole
he's
life.
He's been doing cocaine for a long time.
When like, he said to Fab, I got homies that like homies. And
yeah,
shit.
Nigga,
he's like, yeah,
whoa, wait, what?
Bro,
you don't remember that?
What is that from?
Why like, do you act like you've never been a part of pop, like pop culture ever?
It's been
ever?
So long that bro, since you, I've been on the podcast, I forgot what life is, what the internet
that?
Was.
Yeah. But that shit might have been like one of the most famous.
Bro, that's what
rants.
Got the Breakfast Club started when yeah. He was when that rant when he was wilding on Fab.
Him and Fab was beefing.
He's like, I got an indoor pool and an outdoor pool. Indoor basketball court and an outdoor basketball.
I don't remember that.
What?
I'll watch that at a later date and time because I need
boy,
to
boy, you are wilding. Yeah. He was like, yeah, I got them niggas that'll fuck booty niggas in the booty. He was like, oh. And then Charlamagne was like, oh, yo, we're going to call you later. Like,
Charlamagne was like, whoa, I'm going to call you later because I need their number because that nigga's a radio host. nope, I'm not. Yeah. Anyway. So,
yo,
time out. So, what year did Whitney Houston die? Can somebody comment on the live?
This nigga's coming on the line. Yo, this nigga's
I'm
on
trying
a fucking
to be interactive.
Roll.
Yeah, bro, it's been a roll. Minute. Niggas don't fuck with me, but I bring value to everyone's life. This is the type of shit I do.
Yo, nobody ever said that. You act like this is like a sitcom, like episodes.
Yeah, it is. Which y'all don't know. We got this shit written out for 137. Nigga been writing me out.
Yo, I've been asking him
where 45.
Word.
He's lying. He's like, yo, he's like, Candy's not coming, right?
No. Nigga.
Yeah, he's look lying. At him. Nigga, like, he's like, no, he's lying. Nigga, Matt, yeah. Fuck you. Nah.
Yo, this nigga.
Yeah.
Candy's not coming, right? Yeah, nah. Yo, you good. You good, Els. Don't even worry about him,
yo, I will flame both of niggas up.
Yeah, nigga gonna flame us. Nigga gonna pull his arm out, like, first off. That's an inside joke for niggas that know Els. Fucking Fantastic forehead ass.
Oh yeah. My god, son.
Nah.
What is wrong with
2012
you?
Nigga, she died
I
in 2012.
I was gonna say 2012 yeah. too. Yeah, okay. I think he was in the early 2000s on no bullshit.
Yeah, so when was he fucking her?
I think like 2005 maybe.
So early 7 years. 7 years before she died.
I think so.
That's close.
I think so.
She was old. How old was she when he was fucking? Like 50, 60?
Does it matter? He was hitting it.
I don't know if that's like a proud.
That's crackhead moment. Pussy though, right?
Yeah.
This is 100% crackhead pussy.
But is she a different type of crackhead? She could smoke an ounce of butter a day.
She got bread though. Yeah. That's
why
every crackhead
is he calling it butter, bro.
Because he's trying to cement the fact he's an Albany nigga. I get it.
We get it. You are old as hell, bro. I don't know why butter. Nobody believes me. You're wild old.
This nigga was born in 83 or something. Nigga came up doing dirt. That nigga was in the clubs when Ja Rule was making hits.
What is about you?
Nigga was wearing jerseys over his shoulder like this. This nigga Els was wearing jerseys like this.
Yeah. But would I be without my baby?
Yo, boy.
That was you.
You know niggas was in secrets when fucking Nelly was like at his peak. Bro, I remember listening to that in Secrets.
Drop down.
Remember they used to have the fucking water cannons.
Water cannons.
Yo, bro, that was the best part.
It really was. No, it used to be hot as the commercial.
No, but the crazy shit is how niggas is in there really at a fake bar.
I wish patience would, nigga. Get the fuck out of here, nigga.
Yo, let me get a, can I get a sex on
the beach? Yo, ma, you want a drink with a fucking umbrella in the fuck? I'll beat your ass,
bro,
nigga.
Hey, yo, ma, you want a drink?
Yo, ma. They was literally setting us up, bro.
Oh, hell yeah.
It's like, oh, these is going to be the patrons.
Oh, hell yeah, nigga.
Said putting niggas on the game early.
You couldn't even dance in there. Like, you get kicked out for a song or two. Like, next little song. You couldn't even, like, really get crazy in there. I got kicked out plenty of times.
Yeah, who hasn't?
You're a black nigga. And we're getting banned.
You two
is gonna get flagged as
violating community rules.
This is about to get flagged as an alt-right. It's about to come in that alt-right video. Mad fucking. You may also like Hitler. the final solution. All Wells World episode 37. Like,
yo, this is episode 44, guys.
No, I'm just saying it's gonna say show your old ones, too.
Bro. Do you know, like, at least four of my last podcasts been taken down because of music?
And I told you because he likes to play 20 fucking minutes.
I told you about the shit.
I told you about the shit with Slip, right?
I told you about the shit with Slip, right?
No.
Me and him was talking about the
You done told this story about 10 times.
You're whispering. Like,
nigga said, yo, so nigga, so we was talking about this shit.
We was talking about the race war or whatever, and I don't feel like we said anything bad, but they banned us for violence.
Why? Because y'all talking about white people?
We wasn't talking about...
Els, how'd you feel about that?
we wasn't talking directly about them,
nah,
but...
What were you saying? Like, oh, these white people gonna do this and that?
No, he just said
I don't even know
like,
what to say. Don't even tell me.
He said some shit like, I wish they would come up here.
Yeah.
Some shit like that.
Oh, so yeah. So you're inciting...
We're inciting... Fuck that.
They could flip it and say like, yeah, you're inviting...
We're not inviting anything.
No, we love white people.
Yes.
I love white. My grandmother's white. My girlfriend's white. You don't gotta do any bombs.
Yo, all right. So
I thought my girlfriend was albino for this whole year. And then I went to the kitchen and she had pumpkin spice muffins. I'm like, oh no.
What is wrong with you?
I got hit by a car.
She had pumpkin spice muffins.
Wait. You thought she was albino.
And then, yeah, and then I was like, pumpkin spice
muffins.
You're
a dickhead.
And then I did some investigation. Come to find out she's white.
You're Caucasian.
Yeah.
You met her father.
Nah.
Her mother.
So I know like light skinned people, you know what I'm saying? Like albinos and red bone people. I don't know.
I don't even think I know an albino black person.
You know they exist.
They do exist.
I know mad albinos. My cousin.
I don't know any.
Imagine someone who has black ass features but white ass skin.
Pigment though. That's
all right. So this is gonna sound ultra racist. We're about to all definitely be alt right. But all right. So listen. So my little god brother, he's like 16, 17. He might be 18 now. He's wow. That's crazy. But anyway, his father is albino, big black. But he's albino.
Mm-hmm.
And like you said, like. He has the most extreme black features.
But his skin is white as shit.
Yes. Like blonde hair.
There's no pigment.
None.
That's crazy.
Like, I'm not even trying to sound racist. Like, son looks like a gorilla. Like, but white. Like, for real.
A white gorilla?
A white gorilla.
Would you rather be an albino or what's that shit that Mike had, like, where your skin start turning?
Alopecia?
Yeah. I thought that was when your eyebrows... You don't have eyebrows.
Vitiligo.
Yeah.
What I say?
He said alopecia.
Oh, Vitiligo.
That's
right.
The hair shit.
Yeah.
That's what he got.
Yo.
Flame on.
You know what I was going to say, but shout out.
Wow. Nah. Never mind.
Yo, did you...
Anyway.
Did you hear about Amazon?
Amazon.com, what, you could buy people on that too?
No, nigga. Like, they're doing a fucking... They're doing, like Amazon Pharmacy now. Like, you can order...
Oh, just talking about Zannies and shit.
Boy.
Nah,
but... Are they really... No, but let's have a talk.
No.
No. You're right. No. You're right. I'm not saying you could just be like, oh, that's not what I'm saying. I want to have a discussion.
Let me get a fucking 100 Zannies.
Is Amazon trying to take over like the United States,
the world? Yeah, they are. Yes.
Bro, think about it. They control streaming. They control TV.
This is
bought Whole Foods.
Yes.
So think that's about wild. This. You're working for a company. Mm-hmm. You could be working for Whole Foods.
Now you work for Amazon.
You work for Amazon. But you're ordering shit off of Amazon.
Right.
You're buying your food from Amazon.
Right.
And now they're trying to do the shit where they have like the store out in San Francisco where like you don't need money. You just literally take shit off the shelf.
And it just like bloop, it's in your car.
Yeah. You feel what I'm saying? But there'll be a point where people are gonna be in debt to that to fucking like you're gonna be
niggas gonna owe Amazon.
And then, rent, then what if you don't then let's say you don't pay your shit, you don't pay your little percentage, bro, you can't fucking buy food, you can't order nothing. You know what I mean? Like they're gonna start
this is getting into some new world order shit.
Nigga, but I'm saying the medicine is what's fucking my head up. Cause it's like, nigga, what are you niggas
He's
trying to do?
The market.
So you gotta think about it like this.
You about to get your every food, company, entertainment, and now your medicine like from
doubled,
them.
This nigga doubled his net worth in COVID.
Facts.
Yeah,
he's about to be the first
that nigga
trillionaire,
took
right?
Everybody. Yeah, he already is, I think.
Is he?
I think.
Or the first known? Because I heard. I heard them. Them.
All right.
Yeah, them niggas salty.
All right. All right.
No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying all like right. The Saudi niggas be having like.
Oh, them niggas got.
They
bread.
Might be trillionaires. No bullshit. Yeah.
But
they, you know what I'm saying?
But,
like the shit they be buying
that's,
is like.
So that's like that's on some like. A whole family, like their yeah, whole family.
That's some trust fund money
okay.
shit.
Okay.
That's like some crazy wild. Yeah, I don't even know how to explain
niggas
it.
Niggas get allowances.
Yeah. Facts. I mean, billion, like, 100 million.
And there's wild princes.
There's yeah.
You
yeah.
know what I mean? Like
yeah, there's like 200 princes.
That's why Dubai is like such a wild ass place because yeah. them niggas just be like. Yeah.
No, it's not even Dubai. A lot of shit you can't do in Dubai. There's like a little. I was watching this shit. There's like this little country.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, the shit is like probably the size of Rhode Island or some shit like that. It's like right by Dubai, but them niggas go
UAE,
over there
yeah.
to do shit.
United Arab Emirates.
Now I don't even think it's UAE. I think it's something else. But them niggas go there to drink and to party and to
oh,
do shit
okay.
like you know what I mean?
Because
in Saudi, all
because
that shit is illegal.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Because
yeah,
the Muslims,
right,
it's right, Muslim,
right.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's
yeah,
like
it
this little
sense.
Country.
Yeah.
That's,
so all the dignitaries and like you know, like the socialites and shit from like fucking Qatar and all that
yeah,
shit too. Yeah.
That makes
you
sense.
See what happened to fucking what's my son? Future DJ.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
For just for having a little bit of weed.
DJ Esco. Yeah.
56 nights in jail, nigga. And he, I think he got like whipped on his hand or some crazy shit.
Did
they got
he?
Ten, they got
yeah.
10 lashes or some wild shit.
Bro, they don't fuck around out there.
Nigga, he's a DJ. How they gonna
yeah.
do that?
You want a DJ? You'll never do it again on 100 lashes. Yeah, bro. Like, bro, that shit probably. I don't think that nigga ever did no wash like that ever again.
Yo,
think about it.
100 lashes.
And they do that shit on TV.
Word?
Yeah,
they gonna publicize their punishment?
Whoa. They public execution over
what
there.
What year is it?
You getting your head chopped off on PBS.
Word. Right after the Antique Road Show.
coming up, it's 6 o'clock. We got the beheading of DJ Escrow. but first, your news.
Today, the weather.
No, my boy.
Sunny.
Fucking Borat. Yo, did you see the new Borat?
The new Borat is fire.
No, I didn't.
All right, it's
bro.
Not fire, but
it's
funny.
Funny.
It's funny for what it is. It's all right, so.
You have to know Borat.
Yeah, facts.
You know what I mean?
Facts,
so,
facts.
So, yeah, exactly. So basically,
is it a good Borat movie?
It's a good, for being a Borat movie,
yeah,
it's a good movie.
Okay.
You know, I feel like they went crazy on like having a story. Like, everybody knows
yeah.
what Borat is.
Yeah.
But for them to
there's
have
a, story
like, a crazy,
now.
Stupid storyline,
oh.
but it's still him like. Pranking people like this
yeah.
nigga is literally going to a fucking
but
that here, shop to send emails. You know what I mean? Like
yeah,
he's telling
that's
the nigga
funny.
The wildest shit.
But here's the shit though. Here's the shit that like
that Rudy Giuliani shit.
No, not even that. I don't even care about that. Whatever. What you can't we can't prove that. Like whatever. But you fucking edit video. So like when you watch. That movie, you can see like the fucking editing cuts.
Yeah,
like, oh,
yeah,
so
yeah.
they're cutting shit to make people seem way more racist or way more dumb than they actually are. You know what I'm saying?
Mm. No, that's a fact.
Like when he brought his daughter to the tanning shit, and then he was like, "What would be the darkest you could go for a racist family?" And then they cut it, and then she's like, "I would go here with this one." You know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Yeah.
Mm. Like. It wasn't like the camera panned, and she's like,
yeah.
"I'll go with five."
Yeah.
You know what
it was definitely a cut shot.
Yeah.
She
but like,
probably just didn't say what they thought she was gonna say. Like, I don't know.
Yeah,
you know
yeah,
what I mean?
That,
yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah,
you
yeah.
can tell she was like, I don't, you know what I'm saying? And then they cut like, I'll go with the five.
No, we need this racist lady. So
yeah.
you know, turn the
but,
racism
like, there's,
up.
But like, there's some like certain shit like went. All right, so basically, the whole premise of the movie was he had to go to America to do some dumb shit, right?
But, bring him. Emergency was like, bring a monkey to like Mike Pence or some stupid shit as a gift.
But the monkey was like the top porn star in Kazakhstan or some dumb shit. Some wild shit. Yeah. So anyway,
like they call Mike Pence a pussy hound. Like Kevin called him a pussy hound.
But it's just weird. So anyway, like basically he's saying now Borat's world famous because of the first movie. So it's funny because he's being Borat. And so he's in a character, but he's dressing up like in disguise. Mm. And he has, it's dumb funny. Like
this nigga disguised himself as Donald Trump, bro, and like goes to like
and got into CPAC. Yeah, facts.
And while Mike Pence is fucking talking, like holding his bitch, like I have Pussy Hound Trump or Pussy Hound Pence. I have to get.
I am your best friend. What the fuck? Just crazy, and he got through like TSA, like crazy shit. Wild.
Escorted this nigga clean out the building. Yeah, never Secret Service, ID, you know what I mean?
But I mean, Secret Service ain't. Now I'm gonna say that. I'm never gonna say that.
Fuck that, nigga. Them things is real.
Yeah, bro. They pulled up on Rosie.
Them niggas is real.
Bro, I was sitting there like, you niggas, okay, bro. You ever seen that movie Ninja Assassin, I think it's called? No. You seen Ninja Assassin with the dude? He's like, he was a former ninja, and like these niggas just popping out the shadows like Darkness Falls. Bro, when I tell you that's how these niggas just like
appeared, you ever see, like, they that just appeared. Bro, that shit was weird as fuck.
Paper Mario, where like you can see him and then he turns, you can't see because he's a paper. Yeah. Them niggas was like that, boy. They just turned him.
Mad inconspicuous. Nigga, when I was done spazzing on the nigga, I looked around like, oh,
bro, there was at least
formed up on you.
All right, we were, bro, literally all
a whole barricade. Like, nigga, I can act crazy if you want, but take you out.
We would have went missing, nigga. There would be no OL's world.
Niggas would be in Guantanamo. Nigga, I looked around like
they would have shipped to Black Site.
Yo, y'all trying
Black Site 7? Yeah.
Yo, y'all trying
in Hungary.
Safe house.
Word.
Y'all trying to leave?
The word. Said Gray Site B. Like what? Some shit you never heard of.
Say y'all trying to leave? We're just gonna be like, y'all want to get up out of here?
We're just gonna be here like for the whole 4 years, and then
at least I'm saying they probably came a long way, man. You know what I'm saying? As a Secret Service. Like, when's the last assassination attempt?
John F.
Word, Kennedy. Because we'll never know. I feel like dudes probably tried to off Obama a lot. I feel like it had to have. Mm-hmm. You know how many
people? Oh, they was knocking down niggas' doors.
Oh, yeah.
About Obama.
He was making random tweets. He was getting a visit.
You ever seen fucking what's his name?
No, I haven't. I don't care. Next subject. So, nah.
Damn.
I don't care.
What's that shit? Snowden?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
That shit is real, bro. Those niggas is like,
oh, who's just looking up like their exes, like their ex girlfriends, like emails and tech, like weird shit.
Nudes and shit. Facts. He's like, look, we could turn on this camera. She's about to get.
Niggas, yeah. He said, he said that. Like, he was looking through somebody's camera and he felt weird. Like, I'm dead ass looking into this person's life. Like, that's weird.
Yeah, that's dumb weird.
And that shit was when his girl started thinking he's crazy. Like, what are you talking about? Like, listen, you don't know what the fuck these people could do.
Word, like, word. He's just putting tape over random shit in the house. Like, nigga, what are you doing? Word. But you got to think about that. You're just living with somebody, and they're just putting tape over, like, light sockets. Right. Like, what the fuck are you doing?
They're listen, here, man.
Listen, they can listen. Like, you know what I'm saying?
They're fucking here, bro.
Like, who's here? What? They're
fucking here, man.
Nigga takes your phone, throws it in the fucking microwave, and turns it on for 3 minutes. Like, like what? Oh, I just bought that.
Can we talk about the verse?
Yeah, I was waiting for you, nigga. It's your show. I'm just a guest. I don't even. All right, before we do this, I have to claim you one time. You got the bumper sticker tattoo on your arm, boy.
Yo, this nigga.
No, you don't. That's not a. Yeah, that was a sad tattoo. Why do that?
Yo, because.
I thought so. Back when I was little, I thought that was for Jews. Because
this shit literally has every religious sign.
I was seven, my nigga. I was seven. I was seven, and all I knew was.
Oh, you talking about that?
Yeah.
Oh.
Because I just seen a Jew person had it on their car.
A Jew person. Definitely getting flagged. This is good. This is far right.
All right.
You can just say a Jew.
A Jewish person.
You didn't say Jew.
No, he just said Jew person. Like, oh, she was sounding.
All right, I'm speaking as a 7-year-old that is new to, you know, the world of, you know, different types of people. Because growing up, like I said, my family's everything. So I just thought everyone was everybody. I didn't know the Jewish person was. And then, you know, I learned. And then I learned about the Holocaust, and it was terrible. You know what I'm saying?
It was very bad.
See, we're not alt-right. It was terrible. The Holocaust happened. And then
it did happen.
So I might have been like 4 or 5. Like, I might have been so young that I didn't even realize that, like, black people were, like,
the thing.
Black people?
No, like, got, like, were racist, like, or not were racist, but, like, got racisted. You know what I'm saying? I don't know how to say it.
They were a product of racism.
They were oppressed. I didn't realize black people had been oppressed because I'd never seen it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I just heard about, oh, they killed people for just being Jewish. And I was like, why would you kill someone for just being themselves? I was like 4 or 5. I didn't know.
Mm-hmm.
So when I seen that, I thought that was just for Jewish people. Like, everyone should be nice to Jewish people. That's what I thought.
Clean up on aisle 7.
No, I'm being dead ass. That was just a little story.
So
to segue into, you know, the coexistence of young Jesus.
So let me say this.
Let's talk. Cause I got a.
So leading up to this battle.
So I in. So it's all right. Not even. Let me preface it by saying this: me, myself, him, Ronell, and a friend of ours, Dutch. Shout out to the House of Juice.
Shout out to the House of Juice.
Right.
At the House of Juice.
At the House of
on,
Juice
on Snapchat. Hit him up.
Yeah. So we kind of judge this like versus like a boxing match.
Yes.
And it's actually what it was a unanimous. Draw for us.
Yeah, at first the reason why it was a draw because I felt like,
all right, so
a lot of the rounds, I felt like a lot of the rounds could have been a draw.
No,
but
the fuck they couldn't have.
Can I talk?
You can talk.
Can I
it's
talk?
Your turn and it's your show. Whatever.
Thank you.
It, whatever.
Because you got disrespectful niggas like L's who just be like, "Yo, Gucci's are so trash," and other niggas. Word. Anyway,
Lajeezy.
So I was kind of tight because there was some songs I felt like wasn't just to me as a Gucci fan wasn't they were better than the Jeezy songs. But I listened to it again when I was at work.
And you're like, oh, I was wrong.
Yeah, I was very wrong. Yeah. So I had to, you know, make a couple calls and discuss a couple things.
So yeah, let me put all right. This is my interpretation of the versus battle, and I think I did it the right way. I did it, you know, drinking copious amounts of Hennessy and smoking the loud pack at the same time.
The rapper.
Yeah, the rapper, yes. Mm-hmm. The mama.
Cookies.
You know what I'm saying? That shit. So I was pretty fucked up. Like, by, like, round 5, I was fucked up.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so, because, the shit was supposed to start at 8 and didn't start till 9:30.
Yeah,
it definitely was supposed to start at 8.
I was sitting there ready, like,
let's
ready.
Go. Yeah. I had to go to work. I went to work, like, right after that shit.
Bro, I thought, like, I didn't have the right link. I couldn't. I'm like, there's nothing here except 2 chairs. I think I missed the battle.
Let's talk about the optics.
All right.
First.
All right, so the optics of it. So, first off, nobody was there for mad long. So, I thought somebody died in the back.
Yeah, I'm like, they fought.
Somebody died in the back, right?
it's over.
That's what I thought. And then out of just randomly, 100 niggas came out of nowhere.
And stood on one side.
Yeah, and then Gucci Mane was like, yeah. And you could tell because he's wearing a whole bunch of Gucci.
Yes, as he should be.
As he should be, right?
This nigga, this bum nigga Jeezy got up there with a fucking
leather jersey.
Got on a leather
jersey. Boy, that's bad.
Fuck out of here.
I don't care what, like.
For $10,000, Gucci's outfit was fucking trash.
It wasn't trash.
Trash.
No.
It wasn't trash.
You can't dress so you don't fucking
It doesn't
count.
Matter. It wasn't Ooh. Trash.
His outfit was garbage.
It was basic. I'll
garbage.
Say it was basic. It wasn't
As
trash.
Fuck for $10,000?
Shut up.
So, did you see the whole thing where basically that
no,
was a
I don't
shot.
Believe. No, it wasn't.
So you don't
no, it wasn't. That's it internet isn't. Shit.
That might be internet
that's
shit.
That's internet
but
shit.
But that's good internet
shit. That's a good internet shit.
Good
I'm internet. Rolling that's, with it, too.
That's
I'll believe it.
That's connecting.
That's 2020.
Dots with
I'm rolling
lines.
With it. I'm rolling
but,
with it.
So you, as a Gucci Mane fan, facts, do you know how much was put on Gucci Mane's head?
$10,000.
So this allegedly.
Okay, we're just going to go with that because I don't got time for this nigga to
look on Wikipedia. Right,
Jeezy, keep talking, keep talking. Jeezy ain't never say, oh, I put 10,000 on his head.
Keep talking. I'm pretty sure that was actually a thing.
No, Jeezy never said that.
Okay.
I don't think he ever said
that. I'll take your word for it. La Jeezy. All right. Or, I don't know, La Gerald. I don't know what your real name is. Jeezy is what you, we just call you. So, I mean, if he said that, I don't know if that's true, but that's a cool meme. I'm not even going to bring it up now. You just ruined the whole thing.
Go ahead. Else. Keep talking.
So, basically, someone posted some probably fake shit on the internet saying that Gucci wore the outfit and said it was worth 10 G's because at the time, mm-hmm. when your boy put money on his head, he put 10 racks on his head. So, I'm saying, oh, you putting 10 racks on my head, that's a light outfit. It's a light outfit.
Light. Bitch.
And I don't think that outfit costs $10,000.
No, the jacket probably cost 10 bands. I'm not gonna
lie. What I'm saying, yeah.
But at the end of the day, you had a fucking, the nigga looked like a Timberland, they said. Like, the memes coming out.
Nigga said he looked like fucking Agent Carter in Rush Hour 3. That was funny. Yeah. Wow, that was perfect. That was, you should, like, record that and, like, instead of that, like, that was funny. Okay. That'd be cool.
And fucking, the nigga had on
a guys
brown,
on live?
Brown turtleneck. Brown pants and brown Louboutins. Like, come on.
This nigga had a leather jersey on.
So what?
With a hot ass mink.
He really had on a leather jersey.
And a like, fucking bandana.
And not even like a regular, like, you know, a leather jersey today. In 20,
I'm not
on
saying
a,
that.
He had on a 2007. Saying, like that was the same leather jersey he performed with back in 06.
Did I say that Jeezy had a fire fit?
Yes.
No, I didn't.
Nah, you implied it.
No, I didn't imply shit. I just said Gucci shit was trash for 10,000.
It wasn't trash.
That's like you saying, I say Black Lives Matter, you say All Lives Matter. No, bitch. Let me, I didn't say nothing about
there it. There is no listen, correlation.
Listen. No, none whatsoever. None whatsoever.
No correlation.
But let me ask you this
you
question.
You tried that. I'll give you that.
Else, no. Listen. So if Gucci never brought up the price of his outfit, would it have still been a trash outfit?
I wouldn't even have been thinking about the outfit.
I already knew he was going to try to outdress him because
he said that on Instagram.
Yeah, but I wasn't even thinking of. I'm like, yo, Gucci, when man, Gucci so said that shit, I'm like,
he's
getting beat. He's mad right now. He's
yeah.
He's,
Let me ask you this.
Do you think he came there to even like win?
Yeah.
I don't think he would come there to lose.
Yeah.
That don't seem the like fuck? A Gucci main thing to do. But it wasn't really Gucci. It was Gucci clone. So who knows.
I don't think that's him, bro. I think there's a theory that.
Did you see the video of him doing 100 splits in a row?
Yeah.
That's not the Gucci.
That's not the Gucci.
No, that was motherfucking perked up, zannied out.
Oh, nah, zannies, who the fuck that was? I've seen niggas on zannies. That's not. Zannies don't do that to you.
He was on the e-pill. He's dead.
What the fuck was going on? He might have popped a bean. That is some.
He's a bean, y'all.
Yeah.
Thanks. I smoke perp and I pop beans and I don't give a damn how you feel about me.
I'll give
he
should
have played that other than fucking Plain Jane. I fucking hate that song.
Whatever he would have played, it don't matter.
I fucking hate Jeezy that song.
Played,
so
hard. Jeezy so played hard. Straight classics, bro.
He played his first album.
So what?
Nigga played, classics. Yeah, he definitely played. every classics. Song he played came out before 07.
He played his
and
first
Gucci
album.
Gucci was mad about that. Like, play some current shit.
So then
played Bruno Mars. Bitch ass.
He should have played.
So like the first two rounds, I think Gucci got it. I think it was the first two. The first round, Gucci got it because you know, nigga.
It was a diss, and it was great. I feel like he won all the diss songs.
Yes, but listen. So
that's something like
Gucci won like the first two, I think, and then after that, Jeezy went on like a 7-0 run.
He was wilding. He wilded him right the
you
fuck
know what
up.
I'm saying was bugging, and then then. That's when Gucci was like, play some new song. Play some new song. I'm about to play some shit. And this nigga played a song with Jason Derulo.
Or Bruno
fucking
Mars.
Miguel. Whoever the fuck. He shouldn't have played that song.
He shouldn't have. I'm with you. What song was that? It's called Fly in the Sky, I believe it's called.
Who really gives a fuck?
Yeah. No, that's a good song, though.
I actually like the song.
That's a good
song.
But
he
definitely
shouldn't have played it there.
That was not what he should have played.
Definitely should have.
Oh, hold on. What the Rocky say? It doesn't matter.
But so he played that song, and then what did Jeezy play in response to that song?
I do not know.
But it killed it. It don't even matter.
Yeah. I do not know.
And then, so Jeezy was smoking this nigga, and then this is what happened. He played Truth.
Yeah.
And it was different because the only song, so every song they played like one verse except that first song he did, he did the whole song for the first song.
Yeah.
And then they were like, all right, you're wildin', that took too long. And then they did one verse for everybody, or you just play your verse. And then for Truth. He did the whole, like,
the whole song, the whole both song. Verses.
I know, but that, you know,
and,
what's crazy?
And no. What's crazy, he only rapped the most hurtful parts of the song. That's what's crazy.
Jeezy was only doing one verse for each song.
Yeah.
That's how
it was supposed to be. But I this think, nigga just
I
was
feel
wilding.
Like there might have been one or two songs where he did two verses. The whole,
yeah.
I'm about to say, yeah, because I it wasn't put on. It was some song. I was like, okay, yeah, let him rock.
Yeah.
He should have did. I wish he would have did the second verse to put on. Have back, yeah, back, and nobody. Yo, that's my shit. I'm dead as a Jeezy fan.
We're all Jeezy fans and all Gucci fans. That's the problem. But people had to pick. People had to pick
nigga,
sides.
I know what size I chose, nigga. Don't give a
so
fuck.
This is my thing. All right. Everybody says, yo, Jeezy pussy.
Nah, niggas
is adults. Listen. Not only that, but like, have you ever heard of Gucci putting money on Jeezy's head?
No.
If somebody tried to kill, and I had to break money, yo, you pussy. I said, who's really put, not, you know what I mean? Who's really pussy? Not for nothing. If a nigga put money on your head or send niggas to come get you and you never publicly try to kill this nigga.
So I understand what you're saying. Like, the difference is after the nigga put money on his head, niggas tried to kill him. He killed the niggas that, you know, Pookie Loke, and that was disrespectful. That was crazy.
Wow, disrespectful.
Wow.
I mean, of course you did what you're supposed to do.
At that point, nigga had national news coverage. You know what I'm saying? You're on the news.
I'm still trying to smoke
you.
Can't
at that point go on Smack DVD and be like, oh, I'm about to put 20,000.
No,
on.
You don't do that, but I'm still, there's,
I mean,
going to be a chance. Yeah.
Street shit, you can't say that he never did.
Bro, have you ever heard of somebody, have you ever heard of Jeezy getting shot?
I don't know them like that.
No, I'm just saying, like, New York. Don't you think you would have heard of some shit like that happening? Jeezy's tour bus shut up.
I'm pretty sure shit like that has happened.
I'm saying niggas like, but I see. No, and I do get what you're saying, but there was beef. It wasn't like it was just some old niggas.
And
just
that's
shot
the difference.
That was it. There was dead ass beef.
That's
was.
The difference.
I don't know if
this
Gucci.
Versus.
I don't know if Gucci had enough like strength to really get niggas to shoot. But yeah, I'm saying niggas beat up niggas in their entourage and shit like that. Like Slick Pullin got beat up mad times. You know, BMF don't really fuck with him no more. But BMF was protecting him for a while. You know what I'm saying? So like, I think
that's
all that plays into it.
And that's a cover.
You know what I'm saying?
DMF?
Yeah, you're not fucking with them. You're not fucking with them.
For the, you know what I'm saying?
You're
gang,
just not.
Gang.
You know what I'm saying? But when they split, you know what I'm saying? And but by that time, it might have not even mattered.
I wouldn't have gave a fuck.
Man. I understand what you're saying, like, but at the same time,
I feel you trying to kill me. You send some niggas at me.
Street shit, like, you gotta
I'm coming to highlight you.
Because street shit, listen, street shit, you gotta know when to retaliate and when not to.
But 20 years and 20 years.
But if
listen, now it's really no. You don't think there's been shit where niggas have waited 35 years to kill? Think about like dumb shit like this.
Oh, so now it would be perfect because we made peace.
No. But
we made peace.
All jokes aside, that's how people think. That's how people think, bro. Like, yeah, like we cool. Not even funny. Like, I'm dead ass shit. Like, there's people that really think like that.
Like, oh, what happened with
people? No.
Black youngster and fucking.
And it's not
name?
That I can't shots. Touch you. Look. And it's not that I can't touch you. It's I'm gonna wait for the perfect fucking time and place and fucking opportunity to touch you. You know what I'm saying? So you got.
I feel you.
You know what I'm saying? Gucci had a whole. Then it went to jail for how? You know what I'm saying? Like he had other. Issues he had to deal with.
Mad issues. That's all this nigga. This whole career
was
just issues.
He definitely was pulling up. But what do you do? Push the bitch out the car when he was driving. Facts. Like just mad wild shit.
Wild shit.
That pulling happened. Up on niggas trap houses.
Shit that happened to someone, you know? In Schenectady. But we're not gonna talk about that right. Anyway.
Niggas in Schenectady is booming, bitches.
Yo, it was a good month. What is wrong with you? What's wrong with you?
Shout out to you. Oh, anyway.
Damn, Rolly, you pushing bitches out the car.
Never. No, not Rolly. Nah, Rolly. Hell no.
Never.
Woo, never. Bring them out. Yo, anyway.
I'm not putting this episode out.
This is definitely
he is wilding right now.
It's been a good month or two,
yo,
bro. Niggas,
this is why I don't call the fucking podcast.
Bro, I had a COVID scare. Look, yo, bro, it's been a minute.
Dead look, ass. He just told the truth. You heard what he
this
just said?
This is crazy,
he said,
son.
This is why he don't come
this
on the podcast.
This is why I don't come on the podcast.
He let
now.
It slip
this
out.
Some wild niggas.
Fuck you. So anyway, this is so, nigga. Jeezy went like 7 or 9 straight on, you know,
straight
on Gucci, right? And then Gucci played Truth. And then... Basically, after that, Gucci won almost every round. You
I
know
don't
what I'm saying?
Think so. Not after Truth.
After Truth, he won almost
I think
every
so.
Round.
Because oh. Honestly, for me, I didn't want to hear shit else.
After, yeah. And people were like, oh, bro, this battle, I don't care about the person.
The
this
one
about
thing,
the music. The, and the songs that were played. Not who's better. Like, it's just the verse, it's the songs that they played. Mm-hmm. Gucci could have played way better songs. Way better. There's some songs that Jeezy didn't play as well.
Yes.
We can all agree on that.
Yes. Yeah.
But I feel like Gucci slipped. He fucked up. He didn't play Freaky Girl, bro. That's the first song a lot of people ever heard of Gucci.
Yeah.
Realistically.
I mean, yeah. There's a few, you know, like you said, there's a few songs that Gucci could have played, but I just think that the essence and the aura that that Jeezy's music, you know what I mean? It captivates.
He's just it's a hard he would be hard to beat in the verses because
he makes you want to fucking go and you could not have sold drugs a day in your life. You listen to Jeezy, bro, that nigga make you want to go get a pack.
Niggas say that, but ain't ever gonna go get a pack.
That's the
feeling. He's talking about the feeling.
You know what I mean?
And I think
niggas don't know how that feels. But listen, long story short, this is how I feel it was. I don't count So Icy because who won that round?
Both of their songs.
That was classic for the culture.
So, I didn't see that. That was fire, yeah.
So then other than that, you know what I'm saying? They played 24 songs. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, they did.
So I got it tied up fucking 11-11 and there was two draw rounds.
Mm-hmm.
Now, do you think all right, so the two draw rounds that I had were So Wasted and then Trap, so you know what I'm saying?
Mm.
I'm a T-R-A-P. So
that's better than Wasted. Trap Star is definitely better. That's way better than
now,
Wasted.
Now, I'll give that to you only because I hate Wasted. I just hate that
song. Yeah, that's not. You can't play that verse Trap Star, bro.
No, he played it first.
That was, and that, and that's the problem.
Jeezy played Trap Star first and then he
Jeezy responded to every song. So he had the advantage realistically.
Yeah. I just hate Wasted. So I just hate that song.
That's not
But commercially that's his biggest hit other than Lemonade. And Lemonade's my shit. He won that round too.
Yeah. Definitely won Lemonade. And then I tied this just cuz I didn't want to choose. I tied Bitch I Might Be in Soul Survivor.
I feel like
just cause I don't like Soul Survivor.
I feel like us, we play Bitch I Might Be way more. But Soul Survivor is a banger.
And that's my point. That's why I was like, I can't pick.
Cause in the chat I'm like, nigga, you know me. I've played Bitch I Might Be more. But Soul Survivor is a 100% banger.
I gauge a lot of these shits on the feeling you get when you play the music.
I got nostalgia, bro.
Like, and I think with Jeezy, it's more nostalgic. It gives you a different type of feeling. Certain Gucci songs do that, but I feel like a lot of Gucci songs are like bop shit you play in a party. Yeah. Like, you know what
party
I mean?
Music.
Yeah.
A lot of
it's not the
music,
same as Jeezy shit, bro. Like, I mean, you feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, you're right. I feel you. But I just feel like, nigga, like hearing Bitch I Might
to
Be
to me, you know what that verses was? That verses was Jadakiss and Fab.
That's
like,
a fact.
Where Fab was like, what the fuck are you playing?
What are you playing?
You feel what I'm saying? To me, that's how I looked at it. And I knew that's how it was gonna be because Gucci's music is all over the place.
That's a fact.
Yeah. You feel what I'm saying?
Okay, I see what you're
where
saying.
Where Jeezy shit stays in this one lane, bro.
It's
you
one
feel
lane.
What I'm saying? And it's always gonna have the same feeling every time.
Yeah.
Gucci shit is just all over the place.
Mm.
You don't know what the fuck to play.
Yeah.
What to pick.
I guess.
You feel what I'm saying?
So did you judge each round? So I had it, you know, that night right after, I had it a draw. I had it, you know, draw, you know what I'm saying? You had it for Gucci and then Dutch had it for Jeezy.
Mm. But after, you feel me, like I had to take my Gucci fanism off.
Fanboy.
You feel me?
I didn't rewatch it yet. I just
but
watched
once
it.
Once I took the fan, I'm like, damn, he's getting smoked.
Yeah, he was getting and in the chat, like, I had early on, it was like 6-2, 7-2. Yeah. And these niggas was like, you're bugging.
You're wilding.
No, I'm not.
Because the one thing where me and Tamel, shout out my nigga Mel, we argued about was when Gucci played Steady Mobbin, when he played the Steady Mobbin verse, and then Jeezy played his Shorty Low verse. You feel me?
Me personally, Dano killed that.
As a Gucci fan, I'm always gonna go with Steady Mobbin, only because that was Gucci's first Grammy. You know what I'm saying? And then that shit with, I feel like he low-key got the better of Lil Wayne, and Lil Wayne was the greatest rapper at that time. You know what I'm saying? So for me, the moment is bigger.
I don't even know he got a Grammy for that.
Yeah, he got a Grammy for that shit. But Dano.
Dano.
That Me and all my friends. I remember me and all my friends being in parties. Young Jizzo, Big in Paper, yelling at the top of our fucking lungs, doing like singing the whole
looking
shit.
Looking for other groups of people to fight for no fucking reason.
That song.
That's the deal. That's why Bankroll Fresh
are two songs that I think other artists carried those songs.
But remember, Gucci said that he was like, "Damn, man, he sure carries your ass on that one."
Yeah, he cared. Definitely, he
carried it to it's a platinum plaque.
And I said that to OZ. Shout out to OZ. When me and OZ was watching, I was like, "Nigga, that's Bankroll. That's Bankroll Fresh." But the song is a banger. Yeah. That is a banger. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, shit. He played the shit with Drake, and I'm like, that cheat code. You know what I mean?
Cheat code. Yeah. Cheat code, and I said that he's losing. He gotta start playing cheat code. So he started. But then
Jeezy came back with
Hov.
And he won that round.
I'm like, damn.
I think that's how I think it was. I think for Jeezy and them, it's like, all right, if he plays this,
we're gonna do this.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Did you niggas see like what's that shit? Queen of the Gambit.
No,
that, you gotta watch that shit.
I'm not doing that.
All right, whatever. But anyway, it's a part in there where they do some shit like that. Like they strategize, like, oh, if they do this, we doing this. They do this. We
that's
doing
the
that.
Shit about the girl that plays chess.
Yeah, it's fire.
Yeah, so that's how you play chess. If someone does this, you do this.
Duh. He's a dick. He is a dick.
Well, you don't have to watch his show. You just know how to play chess.
That's not about the playing chess shit, bitch.
Yes, it is. We just what you just said.
Just shut the fuck up.
Yeah, you're talking to yourself right now. Shut up and
all
record.
All in all,
it's like now fuck with
all
you.
All in all,
you don't know. You don't need to watch that show. You don't need to watch his verses.
Damn.
Jeezy won.
Jeezy did win.
Let's get a round of applause for that one. Everybody come to a consensus.
I'll say Jeezy won so I don't have to hear nothing on Facebook.
But Gucci's my favorite fucking rapper. Gucci's my favorite fucking rapper, and I'm always gonna be bumping.
I'm gonna say this: Gucci lost because he didn't play certain songs.
He didn't play mad fucking songs. DJ Holiday, you fucking bitch.
So another.
He didn't play any.
Oh,
he's
got me tight, boy. Like, yo, bro, there was mad songs he should have played.
Yo, did you listen to since you know we're talking about your fanboy?
Talk to me.
Did you listen to Meg Thee Stallion's album?
Yes, and it was.
Yo,
but that first
she's snitching now. Nah, now first, she's snitching. We gonna talk about first, it now. Nah, fuck that. We talking about that.
First, that shot's fired shit. She tried to wow his ass up.
She's snitching now. She's a snitch.
She tried to wow him up.
At first, she wasn't telling. Now she's telling. And now let's talk about it. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about, too. You know what I'm talking about. That's why he's laughing like that. She's a snitch.
What'd she say?
Yeah. No, because y'all was flaming me because I called her a snitch. It's going crazy.
She's a snitch. Did you see what she did?
Duh.
I shared some shit on Facebook, boy. So apparently she like made some shit basically saying how Tory was trying to pay her off and her friend off.
Yeah.
She's snitching now. Like, yeah, he tried to get me money.
He's doing too much.
Yo,
like, now,
so what
now
do you think about this?
Telling.
What do you think about this? So when
he
I was
shot, fuck, he shot that bitch.
I don't think he shot her. But it's crazy how like she come out with a diss track. Somebody just said it's like a double standard. I think he tweeted that. He like, yo, this is double standard now.
Facts.
Like
facts. I thought the shit was hilarious, but anyway.
And people were saying that I don't see how he was dissing her. On any song, did you listen to that Daystar shit, bro?
Oh.
He did not diss her. There's not one track on there.
I gotta re-listen. I feel.
Yo, every time I see
you might
this
be right.
Nigga, every time I see this nigga, he's getting blacker and blacker, bro.
Right? I like, said some shit to him today.
Nigga,
I'm like.
Nigga,
okay.
He got on Tim's now, do-rag.
Right, like, nigga got the sweats on. This nigga
do-rag matching the sweats.
This nigga, after this, he's gonna write to a Rough Riders fucking
yo,
video.
Yo, which
shoot,
I need
nigga.
To do. Y'all need.
Niggas wanna crap.
Yo, y'all gotta go back and watch the first podcast with Kanan. We're gonna do, the evolution of Kanan.
nigga had a short fro with a fucking, with soccer.
The evolution of Kanan, bro. Yo, we're about to get on the screenshots together.
It's the winter,
together.
My nigga. I'm cold.
Get on the screenshots together and just like make a slide of that shit.
This nigga was like, I don't give a fuck.
Yo, dead ass. His whole demeanor changed.
Like, I don't give a
fuck. I'm like, fuck niggas. Fuck bitches. Get money, nigga.
Yo, you are hilarious, boy.
Fuck y'all.
Yo, but yeah, man. The verses was great, man. It was great optics.
Was it though?
Yeah, I like the whole aesthetic. I like
did you
doing
feel
it
bad
in Magic
for,
City
for Juicy for fucking Jeezy when he was like, you've been tormenting me for 20 years. How'd y'all feel about that part?
Well, after he said 15,
he was like 15.
Yeah, where he like, no, nigga, it's only been 15.
I think that was all planned. Like that little speech he gave, because you see how it literally went into the next song.
Yeah, no, that nigga was.
He planned it. I don't think it was planned.
I think that Jeezy planned. Okay, you know what I mean? Like, when he plays Correct Truth, I'm gonna do this shit.
Try to look like the more positive person.
I'm the realest nigga in it. You know what I mean? Know.
Like, just and it went right into that song.
What they give? That song is fire too, though.
But Truth won.
Truth won.
I don't care.
Violet.
Nigga, and he sung the most dish. Nigga said, "Go dig your partner up, nigga. Betty can't say shit." And he was cheesing after he said that shit too.
The crazy shit is after the song go off, and he like, "Niggas, just send some more." They go,
"Boy, did you see the video? Did you see the Truth video? Because he did that same shit in the video. Mm-hmm. Like, but you can't say shit." Just stop rapping. Like, yo, you have more to that versus Gucci.
Word, and it just said it in the background. He was just looking with his. Never mind.
He was dumb black nigga. Nigga had gold ass teeth.
Nigga had the Gucci Mane lips. Yes.
Shout, but shout it.
Nigga's lips looked like the back of an iPhone, boy. Shit was shiny. What's your Facebook name?
Here we go. Do not say
No, I'm saying. I'm trying to help you out. I tagged you in that one post. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, is there anything you wanted to get to?
Yeah, I'm trying to get home. It's like, nah. So the verses was, I don't know. What else is going on in the world? The Steelers are undefeated.
Trump really is trying to leave.
Trump is like, I'm not going. No, I'm not going. Yeah. I'm not going anywhere.
That nigga is, yo.
Bro, we are living in the wildest year of.
He literally, like, bro, he is trying to destabilize democracy. The world. Period, bro.
Listen,
like,
I'm letting you guys. I'm still president.
He lost.
I won the election.
He lost.
Trump 2020. I was president for all of 2020. I said what I was going to do. I said that. I said Trump 2020, and I did it.
I have people in place. I have people that will confirm that I won.
Said stand down and stand by, real niggas worldwide.
Real niggas worldwide.
Niggas, a shout out to the Woo. My niggas on Staten, I know you voted for me. Staten was red, but New York is blue. It's racism, really. Racism. I don't know. Kamala Harris with the blacks.
Is it Kamala or Kamala? How are you saying?
Kamala, Pamela. She was on Gina. And Martin, whatever the show was called.
And then what about, what's up with Joe asking us for bread?
Who?
I see Joe. He asking who for bread?
He asked me. I don't know. I don't know. No one named Joe. I don't know a single person in the world ever named Joe. Ever mind.
Are he asking for bread?
From who?
For what? For funds? Because President Trump isn't trying to concede.
Nigga, that nigga lost, boy. You need to send me some bread. How about that?
Them niggas will whack Trump off.
Hey, yo. I don't know.
Hey, yo.
Say with the little.
Yeah. Hey,
said
yo.
I'm not going anywhere till you whack me off. You gotta pull me by my cock if you want me to get out of here.
Hey,
ask Melania. She won't even use her mouth anymore.
Hey,
it's ridiculous.
Hey, yo.
Yo, you think so? What's Trump gonna do after he leaves the White House?
He's not gonna leave.
What the fuck was that,
nigga? That was a neuralizer. He tried to fucking.
Yeah, you're fucking done, buddy.
You try to wipe your memory. What's the score right now? Is this game on right now?
28-34.
Who's, whoa, 28-34?
Yeah.
Who's winning?
LA. But they just did some dumb shit. Who are they playing? Gave them a safety, the Jets.
Oh, never mind. I'm thinking of something else.
Yeah. You got anything, LaTerrence?
No, I don't have anything. Ronald.
What's
Ronell.
What's new in the world? Yo, so, you know, Rondell. I got a bone to pick because, no. What are you doing?
Wait, we're going to end this. Then we can. I still want to talk because I got some shit I want to tell y'all.
So you're not popping on Facebook Live. Go on Spotify. He don't fuck with you. I fuck with y'all. I want y'all to be here. Comment if you like me, but better than Ronell on the Facebook Live.
Please make sure that you like, you comment, no, and you subscribe. No.
Comment the whole time and tell me how bad Ronell was at this.
For YouTube, make sure you hit that notification button.
The bell.
When
gang. I click the bell gang. So you get notifications, my nigga.
About how. And, yeah.
I learned that from a British kid.
What you been listening to, real quick?
Bro, real quick. How come every YouTube video you watch about any subject, it's just somebody from Great Britain, just like, hello, this is Thing for Game, I hear. This is how you can get a PS5 online. Like, it's just some British kid yelling at the top of his lungs. Because
they, like, know everything.
Yeah, and they're like, subscribe now to get entered into a raffle for a PS5. I'm like, I kind of want to subscribe, but
you,
I don't.
What you be listening to?
Oh, man. I don't know. What have I been listening to?
Bro, there's been mad music dropping.
Yeah. You know what I listened to yesterday? I listened to that Pluto X, the baby Pluto shit. Yeah. Is that...
Is a new one out yet? Yeah. Is there like the deluxe? Is it out yet?
Oh, there's a deluxe out?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Me neither. I knew. I'm lying. Like a fuck.
You
I
just knew, said you knew.
I'm gonna say
piece I knew of it was, shit. Oh, here it is, deluxe.
Wow.
So there's more song. There's more songs.
There's more.
Wow. Why are these? So I gotta listen to it again. But
yes.
So I would say listen to that. It's probably cool.
No.
That was the wrong one.
Yeah.
Oh, should I listen to? Oh, so the song I'm gonna play, that one right there.
You got it. Oh, you're not there.
Are you gonna play his song first, even though you asked me? That's yes. Rude. No, we're not doing that.
No,
I'm being a baby bitch right now.
Came and said what?
Eat a dick.
That is what he said. This is. Future Lil Uzi, drinking and smoking.
This is my shit.
Yeah, this shit. Cause you're light skinned. Fuck you.
That's not nice.
The last time I checked, you're light skinned.
I'm not. I'm darker than that. I'm caramel. You're red bone.
That's light skinned as fuck to say you're caramel.
You're
yeah that's right.
I'm copper tone.
Did you just call this nigga a red bone?
That's yeah. Gay as hell.
Nigga, I'm not gay. I'm. What is this song? Who picked this song? I didn't hear anyone pick this song. What song is this?
That is 2 Chainz, Gray Area.
Who picked this song?
L's choice L's. Did of you, the I, week.
Can you say that out loud, L's?
I picked this song.
Okay, L's picked it. Straight to the honor, old enough to
be your daddy, young enough to fuck your mama.
Old enough to be your daddy, young enough to fuck your mama. You are pretty old. Enough to be your daddy, young enough to fuck your mama, young enough to fuck your sister, young enough nigga, to fuck your lyrics. Look. I ain't messing with your granny, I just jugged the out them Xanax. I'm a beast. Nigga sat I'm here. He sat here like this, staring at the lyrics on the screen go down. Too much lyrics for 3 whole songs.
Take my shot, just like Marcus Kemp. I'm so hot, they fanning. Yo, I'm about to get banned.
Bro.
That shit go crazy.
Fire. That shit fire. That's a great song.
You know
what's
crazy, though? How he dropped the same day as Pluto and him. Didn't do no, like, no that album. Promo. That album is kind of better than Future and them shit.
Bro. Nah, the Future album is the Future and the, at least the non-deluxe. I haven't heard of the deluxe edition yet. I didn't know it came out, but it's not that great. Not gonna lie.
Songs kind of grew on me more.
The songs
that I,
grow
that
on I, you yeah. more, yeah. But like, off first listen, it's like I could do without many yeah. of these songs.
So
for there's my no, like, there's not many instant hitters, no. if that makes sense.
We're on 2 Chainz or on
the Pluto X yeah. baby okay. Pluto shit. But so, they got good songs though.
So for my selection this week, I took it back. The verses really made me go back into Gucci's catalog. And this is a song.
It's like me and Candy did the
by
same shit.
Brick Squad. It's called Candy Lady Remix. And this is my shit. I don't give a fuck.
What's up, Juice?
This was my shit.
This?
Yes.
Frenchie.
I don't care. I just like, and I like all the verses in this shit.
I want to change my pick for the week. Boogers on my mind, blow my nose with the money. I'm changing my pick.
Scooch. It's the burr, burr. Yo, L's. We out.
We out.
We out.
Don't look for me to cater.